Let's address the elephant in the room. It's 2022, and the COVID-19 public health nightmare continues to dictate how we live. Vaccines have helped prevent severe COVID-19 cases, but new variants continue to surface. At Berkeley, my research team and I are hard at work in the lab trying to develop a new treatment for COVID. Our ultimate goal is to help people and to stop this ongoing arms race with the virus. We first started our research by learning how the SARS-CoV-2 virus works. Shown here in red, it enters the body, hijacks our own machinery to become a copy machine to produce tons of virus copies for more infection and spread. We then studied the genetic makeup of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, and we were able to find the key code in the viral RNA that allows the copy machine to run, and that all the variants, including Delta and Omicron, share the same key code. This was significant because now we had a target. With a target in our crossfire, we modified the existing genetic technology to make products designed to specifically disable that key code. I tested these modified products shown here in blue. They're known as locked nucleic acid antisense oligonucleotides, or just ASOs for short. Now, I was able to isolate just one of these ASOs that appears to accomplish our goal. The ASO that I developed can be inhaled through the nose. That delivers the treatment directly to the airways and lungs. Once there, the ASO binds to that viral key code, jams the copy machine, and stops the virus from making more copies. Next, while rocking the trendiest scientific safety gear, I tested the inhaled ASO in mice infected with COVID-19. First, on the top right, this is a lung sample from a mouse infected with COVID-19 that has not been treated. You can see the severe infection all over in the dark spots. Directly below is a lung sample from an infected mouse that was treated with the inhaled ASO. As you can see, the virus was almost undetectable in this lung sample compared to the untreated mouse. Look, we still have a lot of work to do. The research is currently under peer review. If it is published, then some scientists above my pay grade would have to apply the research in clinical trials to ensure it is safe and effective for humans. But can you imagine what a game changer it would be if we could fight this virus by just taking a breath? Here's to hoping.